100% after that war with Von Wagner last week. We wish him the best in his recovery.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, Apollo Crews.
We saw Temper's flare earlier. We've seen really both these superstars going back and forth the last few weeks. And as we've already said, time for talk is over here tonight.
And his opponent, representing Diamond Mine, Roderick Strong.
Well, 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 as I look around, I don't necessarily see Diamond Mine with their so-called leader, Roderick Strong.
You know, where the hell are the Creeds right now? Where the hell is Damon Kemp? They are supposed to be in the corner of the leader, Roderick Strong. That is what a team does. They back up their man. Once again, to me, this is proving something that I've suspected all along when it comes to the Creeds. They are all take, and they are no give.
Oh, hold on. You heard from the Creed brothers. Julius specifically, Roderick Strong lied to the Creed brothers last week. Do you not remember? Oh, yeah, I'll be there, guys. Yeah, I'll be there on time. I'll show up. And they didn't show up.
No, he explained that. That was a test. He was giving a test to the Creeds.
That was a BS excuse. Come on.
No, a lot of people out there suspected the Creeds couldn't do it without Roderick Strong. I'll be honest, I was one of them. Strong had faith in them, though. He sent them out on their own to grow, to develop, to learn that they can stand on their own 2 feet. And this is how they thank him.
Well, let's look at these two superstars that are in the ring right now, because on social media last week, Strong took exception to Crews visiting the Diamond Dojo.
Yeah, of course he should.
Why?
Because Apollo Crews is not part of the Diamond Mine. You don't just walk in off the street willy-nilly and step on the hallowed ground of the Diamond Mine Dojo.
Oh, wait a minute. So now it's sacred ground, but when Pretty Deadly destroyed it 2 months ago, 3 months ago, you thought it was funny, ha-ha, and hee-hee?
Completely different. The Diamond Mine Dojo back then wasn't the prestigious place that it is today. But let me tell you about this. Here's the issue with Apollo Crews. Not just stomping around in there, now trying to call the shots, stirring up trouble with the likes of the Creeds, and the Creeds are so naive. They're listening.
Let me pull you up on something here. Apollo Crews has an amateur background. What's wrong with him wanting to lend a helping hand? You're talking about a former champion in the WWE.
Quite simple. He's not welcome in the Diamond Mine. He's not been invited to the Diamond Mine. You can have all the technical skills in the world, but with the wrong attitude, you don't get through the doors of the Diamond Mine. That is Apollo Crews' problem. He has a bad attitude, and that bad attitude is rubbing off on the likes of Julius Creed.
So you talk about you talk about the championship pedigree, the five-tool player that Apollo Crews is. Is we got a little bit of stalemate between he and Strong right now. So no one in Diamond Mine could learn from Crews. Roderick Strong couldn't learn from Apollo Crews.
He could learn elements, but it's the whole bad apple philosophy. Put one bad apple in a barrel of good apples, it will rot the whole bunch. And that is what Apollo Crews threatens to do with the Diamond Mine. I have all the respect in the world for Apollo Crews and his abilities. Let's face it, he's been to the top, he's competed at WrestleMania, he's been a former US champion of all things. The man is really good, but he's not Diamond Mine material, that's for sure.
He's in control at this moment. You mentioned the United States Championship. How about the match last night? Bobby Lashley and former NXT champion Tommaso Ciampa.
Oh, Ciampa.
What a match.
A few doubters. I know he ended up losing the match somehow. He could have won very easily. A lot of people around the world suddenly opening their eyes to just how good Ciampa is, something we at NXT have known for years.
And some people opening their eyes to just how good Apollo Crews is. Wants to remind all of those one of the reasons he came back to NXT, and this is the sort of competition Crews was looking for when returning to NXT, was to face superstars the caliber of Roderick Strong, with all due respect.
Yeah, but what he's saying and what he's doing are two different things. He wants to come into NXT, he also wants to jump the line for championship opportunities, which has rubbed a number of people up the wrong way, and now apparently he's sniffing around trying to take ownership of the Diamond Mine.
I think you're looking into it a little bit too much. What a drop kick from Crews. Crews just put Roderick Strong on Dream Street, and I think what really got under the skin of Roderick Strong was when Apollo Crews told them to watch the film, as the whole world saw what transpired in that 8-man tag team match a few weeks ago here on NXT.
Okay, you're talking about Diamond Mine against the D'Angelo family once again. I'll recall exactly what happened at the end of that match. One man got pinned, wasn't Roderick Strong.
I'm not getting into this again.
It was Julius Creed. He was the weak link for the Diamond Mine that week. That's what the world saw.
After Roderick Strong hit him with a knee under the jaw, if we can remember that part.
That was an accidental crash caused by the fact that Julius Creed didn't do his job in holding Tony D'Angelo. Go back and watch the footage. I've studied it. You apparently haven't.
Both these superstars now trading shots, and you know what also might have got under Roderick Strong's skin was when Apollo Crews told him to watch a little bit more film. And maybe Strong should watch a little more film. According to some, maybe he should watch some film on leadership.
Roderick Strong has no leadership issues. His only problem is he needs to recruit a better quality of human being in the Diamond Mine, not ingrates who will stab him in the back at the first opportunity. Yes, ingrates. Roderick Strong took the Creeds to the absolute top of this division, the tag division here in NXT, in under a year since they debuted. Unheard of in the history of NXT. That's Roderick Strong who did that, not the Creeds.
Well, when it comes to the Diamond Mine, everyone is an equal, according to Julius Creed. But another dropkick fired in this matchup, this time from Roderick Strong.
Pinpoint accuracy. That's what you can learn from Roderick Strong. Let's take another look. Just when Apollo Crews was getting on top in this matchup, out of nowhere, Roderick Strong doing what he does best, resetting the balance. You talk about equality in the Diamond Mine. I'll tell you something, the Creeds have let their success go to their heads, and it's not helped by the fact that Apollo Crews is there week in, week out now, stirring the pot.
I think it's the jealousy that has been building inside of Roderick Strong. Hey, Strong now could be looking for a huge momentum-building maneuver here against Crews.
No reason for Roderick Strong to be jealous of anybody. He's been there before. He's won championships in NXT.
No. Strong. Look at the leverage from Strong. And Strong just able to take out the feet of Crews. What a back and forth contest this has been. Crews, Strong. These two are going to continue to battle it out here on NXT.